the proverbial trunk, honey. What do you think? See this alligator skin on this faux alligator metal they put on here?
Alligator skin is an expensive luxury leather. Even if there's nothing in it, we can sell it as a blanket chest.
Somebody has souped this trunk up. They put new hinges on the back. They got a lock on the front. Somebody's used it as their treasure trove. Obviously, they don't want somebody getting in here, so, you know, who knows what's in here?
How heavy is it?
Well, let's lift it up.
It feels heavy and exotic. I think it's from South America. I don't think you find too many alligators up here in Toronto.
We've got a bid on this, hoping that it's full of goodies.
But it's not empty, I know that.
Definitely not, no.
We're betting that there's $900 worth of stuff in here.
Five, six, seven, eight, nine.
300 I can live with.
Done.
I love Pelican cases. They're industrial strength cases made for shipping specialized equipment. If I could be any bird, I would be a pelican.
The pelican was $400 or $500 new, and I think whatever's inside is worth way more than the case.
What are you doing there? You know this is our lucky number, matey, so just back off of this one, okay?
We're out of here. This is gonna go on with us.
Seagull, you later.
Come on.
Okay.
Pelican cases always have something valuable inside. I mean, it doesn't take a cranial neurophysiologist to figure that out.
Lose the lock.
I hate freeloaders.
I love that. That is the most obscure-looking thing I've seen at an auction. It really has a surrealist feel to it. I've never seen anything like this. Look at this. It's totally insane.
This is known as outsider art, which is made outside of the established art scene by children, prisoners, and insane asylum patients.
It's made with an antique tool, obviously something from a dentist school. Then it has this weird helmet contraption with clock parts. It's right up my alley.
I don't see any signatures. If this dental head was made by some modern-day Salvador Dali, it would be worth four figures.
Stop playing around. Let's get ready for this auction.
All right, start them off and go 10.
I can't believe how much people are paying for all these bags, even in Canadian dollars. If I don't pay attention, it's smoked meat city.
Here comes the pelican case, and we want it.
Now 700 bits, now 8, can you go 9, now 9? I like your style. Would you go 1,050? Do you go 1,050? Sold, bidder number
2. Hey, wait a minute. Didn't Mark just win our pelican case?
Make some friends at the auction, take a seat, have a coffee, relax.
Can we borrow it, Mark?
You can have that for your room at home and help you sleep at night.
I am the predator, and the pelican is my prey.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, keep those cards up, keep waving around.
You got the pirate's chest there, the pirate's chest. There's something in it.
The payoff on this trunk is on the inside, not the outside.
I'll go 25.
I might shop around a little bit first.
Four simple words. Alligator skin, steamer trunk.
Let's start them off. We're going to go 200, we're going to go 1, 1, 100, now 125. We're going to go 125, now 50, 135, we're going to go 135, now 2, 225.
Hey, back off, Billy. This trunk is ours, matey.
225, now 50, we're going to go 250, 250, 275, 275, now 75.
This trunk isn't even alligator. It's crocodile.
Now 3, we're going to go 3, we're going to go 3, 25, 3.5, 350, now 3.5, 350, 350, 3.5, 325, 3.5, we're going to go 3.5, and gold, your way.
$325 is more than the price of the trunk, so there has to be something valuable inside in order for us to make money.
Hello, darling, how are you?
We gambled big. We spent over $800 on an alligator skin trunk and some sealed suitcases.
Who travels with a case like this?
Nothing legal, nothing illegal. That's it.
The suitcases are a total bust. What's inside this trunk is our last hope. So the number one question, honey, how are we gonna get in this trunk?
I brought these.
Yo, you just happen to have them in your back pocket? Let's see if you can use the sleuth.
All right.
Oh, baby!
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Look at that. Are you ready to open the trunk, honey? Woohoo, baby! Let's see what's in here, look. Oh, look, this is yours. For you. You like the Indian stuff, there you go. A lot of Hot Wheels, $1 a pack.
It looks like a toy trunk full of kids' toys. Lots of Hot Wheels.
Oh, these are movie.
Those are lobby cards. Lobby cards are like small film posters used in a theater to promote a movie. The older and better the movie is, the more valuable the cards are. These are worth probably about $20 to $25 a piece.
These are Three Stooges, we like them.
Laurel and Hardy, Jackie Gleason.
Hey, honey, let me interrupt you. Wizard of Oz, Yellow Brick Road.
That one's worth real money. interestingly, honey, if you look at it, it says here that this was made in 1949 for Lowe's theaters, but the movie came out in 1939. So this may have been like a 10-year anniversary re-release. The Wizard of Oz is one of the most iconic films of all time. But this lobby card dates to 10 years after its original theatrical release. So it really makes me wonder about the value.
How rare do you think this would be?
I don't think there would have been that many lobby cards for The Wizard of Oz. So whether they produced 500 or 200, I'm not sure, because they were just used for a short period of time in a theater.
We're off to see our friend Mike. He runs the Hollywood Canteen, a movie memorabilia shop in Toronto. Hopefully, he can illuminate these lobby cards for us.
We went to an auction, and at the auction, there was this old humpback trunk, and who knew on the side was this collection of lobby cards. We've sold lobby cards before, so we know a little bit about them.
Okay. Here is our beautiful, beautiful piece. Almost every serious film poster collector wants and must have a piece from Wizard of Oz. And a lot of people collect Wizard of Oz stuff, whether it be movie stuff, books, paraphernalia. So you have all those collectors, plus the movie people want to cash in. This is the title card, card number one, clearly marked, from the 1949 release. And of course, the fact that it's 1949 will definitely drop the value.
It's not original, but it is old, it's number one of a set, and hopefully it's historic.
This is in lovely shape for its time. The only thing I can see right off the top is that possibly there's a little fading. When you consider that these things probably did hang in a theater and there was never any effort to conserve this paper up until recently.
That's not bad, yeah.
That's not bad for something that's 70 years old.
Yeah, blimey.
This isn't an original by somebody like Saul Bass, but hopefully it's worth more than the $325 we paid for the trunk.
I've seen the original one sell for as much as $10,000 if it was in pristine condition. Now, this reissue is affordable by collectible standards.
Right.
I think we could get upward to $1,500.
Blimey!
Oh, yeah!
Any Oz collector is going to be very happy as this being their one representative piece.
After all this time, the Emerald City is Toronto.